In this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about swing plane and what that means and some errors that you might be making and not staying on that swing plane, which could be causing you to overcurve the ball, whether it be a hook or a slice. So when we're setting up to the golf ball, so if I grab a golf ball and set up to it, this club is on about a 45 degree angle. And if that represents the plane of the swing. Now, we know that there's some information out there that, you know, the swing plane is always changing, and this is all true, but as a reference point, we could use that line as an indicator of what a swing plane or a swing plane might look like in a neutral type of a setup. If you're a little above it, a little below it, not a big deal, but let's use that as our reference point for the purposes of this video. So if I go ahead and set up, I've got that 45 degree angle that would extend out the end of the club through my body and out behind me. If I get up to the top of my swing and I start to then back out of the shot, right? So the club starts to work down and back too much and the club lays down and gets significantly below that line. Well, this is typical of people that struggle with hooking the golf ball because the club works so far inside and you get stuck that you then path it way out to the right and you try and square that face up, which is going to result in a big curve from right to left for a right-handed golfer or opposite for a lefty. Opposite end of the spectrum. If I get up to the top of my swing on that swing plane, right? And the first thing that I do instead of dumping it under is the trail side stays high and it starts to ride on top of that line for too long. Well, that's a typical over the top. We call it over the top move because you're coming over that plane. And that's typical of slicers of the ball because once you're out here, well, then as you start to rotate, the path starts going way to the left for a right-handed golfer and the face typically is more open to the path, which is going to cause that big slice to the right. So what can we do to help get this club a little bit more on plane? Well, one of my favorite drills is what I call the trail arm drill, where it's simply you could start off by holding the club head side and just swinging the grip side because it's lighter, it's easier to do. So if we set up like we would normally with just the trail hand, I want you to vision that 45 degree angle and I want you to trace right up that 45 degree angle and then right back down that line. So by tracing it up the line and down the line, it's going to help you feel what that plane is and where the club should be approximately. Then you could flip the club around, do it with the club head. Makes it a little bit more challenging because it's a little heavier. But you're going to really get a feel for what your trail arm should do, how it should fold, and how that club works its way up that plane. Once you've done that, then you could add your lead hand and go ahead and do the same thing. Put your lead hand on, but really have your trail hand as the dominant hand here to work it up that plane line and down that plane line. By doing this, you're going to start to reprogram what you're feeling in that takeaway. And especially in the transition and in the downswing, it's going to get that club more on plane, closer to a functional plane. It's going to improve your contact. It's going to minimize your curvature, and you're going to have a lot more fun playing golf.